And so after that excellent women's doubles, we turn our attention now to men's singles, and this is the bottom quarter of the draw. And just look at that, the two-time Olympic champion Lin Dan, the number two seed, didn't progress past the first round, beaten by Tommy Sugiarto, and he's up against Mark Zwiebler. Mark Zwiebler, the former European champion and former finalist here at the Indonesian Open. Reached the final 2 years ago, Mark Zwiebler, unseeded, lost in the final to Li Chongwei. In fact, reached the final here 2 years ago without playing against another seeded player.
That's
an extraordinary run for Mark Zwiebler in 2013. There he is, the 2012 European champion. And Tommy Sugiarto, the man who turned 27 4 days ago, semi-finalist here 2 years ago. And who did he lose to in that semi-final? His opponent of today, Mark Zwiebler. So these two players, both very experienced in world terms. Mark Zwiebler, 31 years of age, born in Bonn in Germany. Tommy Sugiarto, as I was saying, celebrated a birthday just 4 days ago, turned 27. Carol Yarriel of Ireland is our umpire for this one. And it looks as if Mark Zwiebler has chosen to start this near side of the court. Now, when they did meet in the semi-final 2 years ago, it was very comfortable for Zwiebler. 17-10 he won on that occasion, but that's not the last time that these two players have met each other. So for Mark Zwiebler, there he is, two times a medalist at European Championships, gold, as I say, in 2010. In 2012, having been a bronze medalist 2 years earlier. Currently 19 in the world ranking. He has been inside the top 10 1 week. In March last year, he was number 10 on the world ranking. His win-loss record for the year is, by his own standards, a little disappointing. Just one previous second round match, that was at the All England, and apart from that, four first round losses. Well, his first round here was against Scott Evans of Ireland, who of course is the top seed for the European Games in Baku in Azerbaijan, coming up very shortly later this month. So to Tommy Sugiarto, the man who left the national training centre in January earlier this year, his world ranking down three places to number 16 in the world. Has been as high as three, and of course he was bronze medalist at last year's World Championships. One semi-final so far this year, and that was in India, where he beat the man who he beat in the first round here, Lin Dan, the two-time Olympic champion. Coming back from a game deficit in a match lasting an hour and 17 minutes. Well, I can tell you his win-loss record for the year, which we saw just a moment ago, the very worrying thing is the fact that he's only played in four tournaments. He's retired partway through a match in two of those four tournaments. But here you can see this is the sixth meeting. I was telling you that they met in the semi-final here 2 years ago. The last time they met was in the World Championships 2 years ago, in the round of last 16. And there, as I was saying, Carol Yarriel of Ireland is our umpire, Crystal Tam from Malaysia, our service judge. So, Steen, it is worrying. Four tournaments retired partway through. In India, of course, in the semi-final, he retired when a game up partway through the second against Victor Axelsen. And then in Malaysia, where he's obliged to play in a Premier Super Series. He retired at 2 love down against Lin Nan because he had to play.
Yeah, it was the week after India Open. He was clearly injured, so so he had to play. But I mean, if you're injured, I feel, and you're on spot in Kuala Lumpur, I feel it should be possible to consult the tournament doctor and get sort of his consent to saying that it's okay, I'm not playing this tournament, giving the spot to someone else.
And on my left, Tommy Sugiarto, Indonesia. Tommy Sugiarto to serve, love all, play.
So Tommy Sugiarto, far side of the court as we look down against the left-handed former finalist here, Mark Schmiedler. Yeah, I agree with what you were saying there, Steen, because the retirement of this man in the first round of the Malaysian Super Series, of course, so many fans had come in. The match had been planned for the evening session when people were off work, had finished work for the day. And the fans had poured in to see Lin Dan play, and they only got to see 2 points. So, yes, it was bitterly disappointing all round. And it was so clearly that he had a genuine injury that... it's a difficult scenario, isn't it, of course?
I simply think that sometimes the players and coaches, they don't understand the rules thoroughly. So they're afraid to get fined if they withdraw, even if they're at the venue and genuinely ill or injured.
So just explain that to us, Steen, because it's my understanding that... You know, as long as you turn up on site, you don't get fined.
Yeah, probably, but that's what the BWF needs to convince the players that that's the case. And I think it's not the next time Tommy gets injured, he probably will know better. But as long as you're not injured, you don't really pay a whole lot of attention to those kind of rules. And then suddenly you hear someone saying, hey, you have to play, otherwise you won't get...
You'll get fined,
and you don't really know who to speak to, and in all the commotion you feel, oh, it's easier just play 2 rallies and then withdraw.
Yeah, no, I understand that.
So a bit of counselling perhaps needed also from the tournament committee.
But isn't it delightful to see Tommy Sugiarto back? Certainly yesterday in his match against Lin Dan, I thought he looked fit again, 100% fit, because so far this year, I'm not sure we really have, apart from the first couple of rounds in India, I'm not sure we have seen him fully fit. So delightful to see the Indonesian back to the sort of form that took him to a World Championship medal last year. Mark Schwiebler himself has had his injury problems this year. On the final rally of the national championships, badly injured a calf muscle, but still managed to win those national championships.
Service over, 5-4.
It did force him to withdraw from the German Grand Prix gold, which of course was bitterly disappointing for him.
Of course, when the tournament schedule gets on and it's so close to the Olympic qualifying period and so on, you tend to perhaps start a little bit too early after an injury. And that's wide.
Service over.
A great start to this match.
Yeah.
I was thinking that Schwiebler often works quite hard for his victories. Perhaps missing that sort of winning or dangerous smash to score easy points for himself. So he had to work quite hard, even against opponents that he's actually quite a bit better than. Technically, of course, very, very skillful player.
The umpire just saying don't walk off the court.
Yeah. He's talking to his coach, and sometimes there's so much cheering going on in this hall here that it's really difficult to hear even what the umpire says.
Yes.
We had a couple of examples yesterday where the umpire actually had stopped the rally, but the players, they kept on playing because they couldn't hear what he was saying.
Going back to the point you made, Steen, about Mark Schriebler having to work very hard for rallies and matches and wins, and I agree totally with you, but you were saying also that he hasn't got that big winning smash.
No.
And I find it unusual. Most left-handers in badminton have a very good smash.
Yeah.
And it's I don't know whether it's because of the way the feathers go into the shuttle with obviously it makes a difference with a left-hander because the feathers go in right over left as you look down on the shuttle. But you're right, he hasn't got that big weapon. That's well worked. You see, he has to work for that, to play the angled shot.
6-8.
Shots, the left-handers.
Yeah.
And a very, very dangerous smash from that side there, across, because right-handed players need to cover their backhand side. Therefore gets a little bit vulnerable for the cross smash to the forehand.
Yeah, shuttle bounced. Called the fault by the umpire. Yeah, we were struggling to hear that. Fault call, but indeed it was called. That's the cross smash you were talking about.
Yeah.
It obviously missed on that occasion. So a 5-point advantage to Tommy Sugiarto here at the mid-game interval of game number one. Playing as an independent player now, Sugiarto.
Yeah, a good start to the game for Tommy Sugiarto. Has looked fit and in good shape. Quick on his feet.
Yeah. Yeah, he looks quite relaxed too, doesn't he?
Court one, 20 seconds! Court
first
one,
player in badminton
seconds.
History to emulate a parent and win a world championship medal. I had my money on Sung Ji Hyun to be the first to achieve
yeah.
that, but Tommy Sugiarto, all credit to him. Well deserved too it was. And had he not got injured in that semi-final against Chen Long, do you remember he slipped deep into his forehand corner?
I was a bit more focused on the other semi-final. Can't remember it.
Yeah. Well, it was 22-20 in the second game against Chen Long. He of course went on to win the gold medal, but he's certainly injured in an adductor muscle, I think. Oh, missed it. Oh, I think that's worth a challenge.
8-11.
Well, we haven't had one yet today.
No.
And I think maybe our Thailand women's doubles pair weren't aware that challenge was a possibility.
Well, virtually impossible from overhead to tell where the shuttle lands.
Yeah.
So.
8-11, play!
Oh my goodness, completely mistimed, broke the strings of the racket. So 3 points since the mid-game interval and all 3 points to Mark Schriebler. Yeah, Mark Schriebler, is it fair for me to say very much a reactive player, reacting to what his opponent does rather than a proactive player?
Yeah, he's patient in his playing style.
Do you think he could be a little more, take more initiative in the rallies? Do you think
yeah.
that would suit him or not really?
I think it would be the only way to sort of... climb higher in the world ranking than he's been.
Crikey, that was well long. I think you and I have got the drift misread here today, Steen.
Yeah, but that shouldn't be a surprise to us because it's so tricky
no.
in this hole.
Yeah.
So. It would be really, really difficult to read if they're in the same, the two courts, court one and court four, are in the same part of the hole, and therefore you would expect the drift along the court to be the same, but that probably is not the case.
No. Sugiarto coming forward to threaten the net shot.
Strange that Tommy Sugiarto is an independent player now with the level that he's sort of showing here, but sort of hats off to the Indonesian team management for giving the youngsters a chance. We can see in this tournament that that they've definitely progressed. Jonathan Christie beating Tian Cho Chen, and a couple of minutes ago Anthony Jinteng beating Shrikant.
Yeah, both of them, I think, still 17 years of age.
Yes, yeah. and another one of their 17-year-old, Firman, was beaten by Jonathan Christie in an all-Indonesian match in the qualifying tournament. So,
and in fact, he had two match points.
Yeah. So it's a little bit. It says a little bit about the ambition level of the Indonesian management here, that they're not satisfied with semi-finals and bronze medals.
Looking for future champions.
Yes.
Well, by all accounts, it was by mutual consent that Tommy Sugiarto left the National Training Center.
Indonesia.
But he's still a valuable asset to Indonesian badminton.
Yeah.
And it's, quite frankly, in my opinion, it's only the injury problems he's been having as to why his world ranking has dropped outside of the top 10.
Yeah, and in some ways, perhaps his playing style, because it's a little bit hard to see him beating
14,
Lee Chong Wei, Chen Long, with that playing style, because it's so demanding physically.
15,
so I guess some of the thoughts behind this is that if he stays in the national team, he's probably the best player, and he will sort of take a lot of attention that the young ones need in order to reach
Service
for higher
over.
Goals.
14-15. Oh, my goodness, good defense. Well, defending on his knees earlier in that rally, Schwiebler.
16-14.
That's the sort of Lin Dan defense that has become sort of regular now. Even the women's singles are doing it and practicing it. Simply a part of the footwork.
Yeah. It's amazing how the game has progressed. You know, I know I'm an old fogey, but I mean, since my day, and I go back to the first ever Indonesian Open. I played here the first ever Indonesian Open, and it's
14.
Dramatic the way the great game has progressed. Oh, look
at that. Well played.
Nice. Net shot early, didn't he? Gave it a little bit of height so that it came down so close to the net. That's a lovely shot from Mark Schwiebler. Inch perfect, straight down the line from Tommy Sugiarto.
Service over. 18-16.
Yep. Probably wasn't the hardest smash he's ever hit, but my goodness, it was good placement.
Yeah, that's sometimes much more valuable.
anguish on the face of the former European champion.
But I really like the idea of putting a little deception on his shot and then playing it into the net on the front court. Definitely the right idea.
So two quick points for Sugiarto and four game point opportunities. Converts on his first. 21-16. Score confirmed by the umpire. 21-16. And always just seemed to have that slight edge in the opening game. Minutes for that opening game. Yeah, Mark Fweber talking to Wang Chiyun. My goodness, what a difference he as a coach has made in Germany. While he's been based there. By all accounts, technically a very good coach.
Yeah, they seem to have a huge impact. Chinese coaches or Asian coaches, wherever they go in the rest of the world outside of Asia, setting new
court
standards.
Court one, 20 seconds.
And the really good coaches, in my opinion, are those who can sort of merge the Asian style together with the European or American or South American style. You cannot treat all players alike, but you can take the best from each part of the world, so to speak.
Second game, love all, play.
Of course, a lot of Danish players have benefited a lot from Zhang Yunling. Working in Denmark for like almost 30 years now. He's still active.
Oh, yes. Yeah. No, I just like to see a rally like that from Mark Schwiebler.
Yeah.
Where he's a little more creative. So if you'd been courtside, Steen, what would you have said to the German?
Yeah, it depends a little bit about the read of the drift, but I think Mark is playing a little bit up against the wind. It's not like he can't put it long, but I would tell him to move a little bit closer to the net, because it's so important to control the front court. And if I'm right that he's playing a little bit against the drift, I would tell him to use some flat drives a couple of times, so create space on the front court. Hopefully get Tommy Sugiarto to lift. It'd be very nice also if he could use some deceptive shots to get the Indonesian off balance. If you're off balance in drifty conditions, it's really, really hard to control the shuttle, and that should create opportunities for Sweetlock. A bit too high. It's better.
Good rally.
And a presumably easy shot and it's way out compared to the standards these players normally go by. Definitely caught some kind of the drift there.
Yeah.
This corner would be a little bit dangerous due to the side drift, which even if there's a drift against Mark Sweeper, then the side drift will tend to make this corner a little bit fast as well. So the safe corner, so to speak, would be the backhand corner of Tommy Sugiarto.
Points the line. Oh, there's a challenge here. First challenge of the day.
Challenge to the Arco. Hold in.
Well, I thought my instinctive reaction was that it had caught the line. Tommy Sugiarto didn't agree. So Hawkeye will adjudicate for us. Must have been close because Hawkeye really taking his time. Here we go. Yeah.
Just caught the line.
Yeah.
These are the kind of shots that are so difficult to judge correctly. But I guess we have some experienced linesmen here in Indonesia.
Good defense.
Changina Jung Kyung Un, Korea versus Lu Yin and Lu Yong, China. Umpire Irianto Idris, Indonesia.
So I don't remember, Jill. Did Mark Swiebler choose ends when
he
had the coin flip? Yeah. So he must definitely have a feeling that he's at the best end right now. As you'd of course often would choose to finish the game if it's a three-game match. You'd like to finish on the good side. Or at least the side that suits your playing style the best. That's well played by Tommy Sugiarto. He was standing so close to the net. He was about to challenge that one as well, but changed his mind in the last minute, I think. Lost one already.
Service over.
Played this court yesterday as well, Tommy Sugiarto against Lin Dan, so he knows the conditions and he is not afraid to lift from this part of the court, and that's important. He can control the lifts.
Good defense. Good rally. Oh my goodness. Looks down at his racket as the string gone. Oh, it's Riebler.
It's in.
Landed in. Well, what an extraordinary rally. I'm not sure the string did go, but certainly looked down at his racket midway through that rally. Three shots, my goodness me. Quite possibly the longest of the day so far.
Yeah.
Service over. 7-0.
Good defense from Mats Riebler in that rally there, and that's probably one of the things that you could criticize Thomas Hugiato for a little bit, that his smashes are quite the same, powerful but not so steep.
Sign language of our umpire, Carol the Ariel, quite obvious. Somebody's taking photographs with a flashlight, and that's got to be stopped. That's very, very distracting for the players.
What a great lift.
Just wide.
9-7.
Yeah, that was a cool call by the line judge. Oh, goodness, looking at it again.
I would be tempted to challenge that one.
Yeah, well, it's too late now. Now, that's the sort of shot you want to see more of.
Yeah, and that's much more efficient than just firing away.
Yeah, cute angle there from Tommy Sugiarto.
And very, very hard for my sweeper to sort of judge how much speed he's going to insert into the defensive shot himself. That's the beauty of these not so fast paced smashes. Played by Thomas Hugiato, but this is actually the problem for Max Lieber. He worked so hard to score points. He didn't even score a point here.
Yeah.
There were a number of chances at the net, and can you imagine an attacking player like Srikanth Kidambi not killing one of those?
Yeah, it was especially a backhand opportunity at the net that I remember that I thought, crikey, should have put that away.
Yeah. So sometimes you have to sort of invest months in playing a little bit different style in order to sort of get enough opportunities, because when Mark is playing his own normal, a little bit patient playing
seconds.
Style, there isn't going to be a whole lot of opportunities at the net. So perhaps play a little bit of lower tier tournaments and sort of practice this more attacking playing style would benefit him.
Thank you.
Not possible, of course, in the Olympic qualifying period, but ahead of that, 1 or 2 years ahead, that would be a developmental
11,
great idea.
Yeah, and I'm just looking at his results, Mark Schwebler, from this year so far. Five previous tournaments, all five Super Series events, four of those losing in the first round, and that emphasizes your point, really, because, you know, if he was playing one or two lower grade tournaments as well, then he could work on certain aspects of his game. Well, a little bit fortunate to win that rally, Mark Schwebler.
Trailing at the interval in the first game, but get back. Interesting to see if he could do the same here.
Yes, there was more of a deficit in the first game too, wasn't there?
It
was a 5-point deficit, whereas there was only a 4-point deficit in the second game. It looks to me as if he knows he's got to take chances at the net.
He's got to take the chances, he's just not used to it. He's not good enough at it.
Yeah.
Here he comes forward. Probably becomes a little bit uncertain. Is the chance big enough, or should I try to make it bigger? Maybe look at some videos from Taufik Hidayat, a master in that field.
Good pressure from Tommy Sugiarto. The body attack, forcing the weak reply.
13-9.
Two of them, then goes for the angle. That's clever.
I think that's a wrong call.
Well,
it's challenged.
There's a challenge here.
Called out.
No, I wasn't so convinced. I thought the line judge got it right, but
that's
why we need Hawkeye.
Yeah. You're a little bit better position than I am.
Well, Well, the opportunity for players to fade away. Yeah, well, that's a great challenge.
Correction in!
Because it's called in. You were right, Steen. The decision.
And these angled shots going down on the sidelines, really hard to judge where it actually touches down. That's well played.
Yeah.
'Sn't it?
And now Mark is playing way too short. Oh. Lucky.
Yeah.
Very lucky for the German.
Service over. 12-14.
I don't know if we've just gotten used to it or what, Jill, but it feels like the intensity of the audience has gone down a little bit. Maybe they just feel like Tommy is supposed to win this match.
Yeah.
Definitely.
No, I agree with you. There isn't the fever pitch support as we've seen for earlier matches. Defense as well. Yeah.
13-14.
Of course, that's what the international players look for. They look for when the hall is silent, because that's a sign that they play well. Even though we must say that the audience here is great at supporting the international players when they play against other international players. They often take a side. Sometimes it's one part of the hall taking one side and the other part of the hall taking the other, so that makes this enjoyable.
I seem to remember a player at the same time as me, Steve Butler, actually playing against an Indonesian in this arena and got the crowd on his side because he wound up the crowd. He started sort of waving his arms about, come on, cheer for me, and he won them over.
Yeah.
So the fans here in Indonesia, I mean, they're very vocal for their home players, but they're also fair. They understand good badminton.
Yeah, and that's a key point. They understand good badminton.
Yeah. Ooh, oh, that's wild. Oh.
Yeah. I think they're a little bit more silent than before the audience, and I actually think it's now that Tommy needs it.
Yeah.
Lift him the last 6 points here.
That's good judgment. Nice. It was a very, very short lift there.
Service over.
Deserved
14-16.
A winner.
The risky shot from Mark Sweeper, but so well executed. Was leaping and yet performing this drop shot. Very, very small margin for success there. It could go either into the net or be too long and easily retrievable.
Of Mark Schwieber. Who knows, it's really now or never. There's another challenge. Once again, it was called out by the line judge.
Mark Schwieber, challenge.
Well, he was right the last time he challenged. On that sideline.
I think it might be just a little bit more to the left this time.
So you think out, possibly?
I think out, or maybe it just touches the line.
Yeah. Desperately close, I know that. Here we go. Here's Hawkeye. No, it was out. You're right again, Steve.
Service over. 17-14. Play.
Yeah, so he, like his opponent, now only one challenge remaining. Defensive shot to me from the left-hander. Just sort of fell towards the shuttle rather than moving the feet.
Yeah, I agree. And we saw that also in the last rally, the long one there that ended with the challenge, that there was some peculiar footwork.
From Schwieber.
From Schwieber, I think it's pretty much last call now. For him, if he wants to get back in this match.
Service over.
Yeah, desperately, desperately 15, needs a little run of points right 18. Now. Sugiharto got wheel spin.
And lots of applause for Mark Schwieber here.
Yeah, and that's nice. That just proving the point we were making earlier. The fans enjoy a good rally.
Here it comes.
Yep. Yeah, slips.
It's not home safe yet.
No.
16.
Sugiharto, because he's going to change here. 2-point lead. It's actually nothing. Especially if you yourself feel that it's a big lead and you've got everything covered. Thank you.
Rublev desperately throwing everything into that rally.
Service over. 19-16.
Now it's still worth the fight. Great effort to get back to play that round the head downward shot.
18,
I'm reluctant to call it a smash. And now just 1 point in it. Yeah. Back level. Well. Nineteen all. No, you can never write Zwiebler off. He's a great fighter. Oh, good neck shot.
Oh! Fantastic save.
Brilliant, brilliant defense from Tommy Sugiarto. But my goodness me, doesn't that emphasize the point that Steen Pedersen was making right at the start of this match? Mark Zwiebler lacking the winning smash. The ability to put the shuttle away. There's no doubting his effort, there's no doubting his commitment.
What
a rally 20. To get match Tommy Sugiarto to a match point opportunity.
And now they're backing him.
Yeah. Fans engaged now.
Oh, there's almost a full start.
Yeah. Not called, so.
It's
gone long.
Service over.
Missed opportunity from Tommy Sugiarto. A match point saved by Zwiebler. He did awfully well to get out of the way of this.
20 all.
No doubt it was long. So 20 all. Extra points required. Until there's a 2 point difference. Unless, of course, we got to 29 all, and then it's sudden death.
Good net play.
Well, having saved a match point opportunity,
20.
Now Mark Zwiebler as a game point opportunity to send this to a third and deciding game.
And he's found new energy.
Yeah. Oh, it's come back in. And a stunned silence from the fans here in Astora Stadium, because Mark Zwiebler has come back from the brink.
One game
he walked to the edge of the precipice, he looked over, saved the match point. is converted and he will fight in the third and deciding game. Well, 16-19 down at one stage, Mark Schriebler. We said he was a fighter. My goodness, hasn't he proved that? It's one game all. And we're just 6 minutes shy of the hour mark. Both players back on court.
Court one, 20 seconds.
Sugiarto must be absolutely kicking himself to give away that advantage.
Final
and
game.
Miss on match point opportunity.
Love all.
Smashed long.
Play.
Well, we thought towards the latter stages of that
one
second game
up.
That Mark Schriebler was looking decidedly tired. He'll have a new lease of life now. He'll be inspired by the opportunity to play this third game. But
and actually, Tommy, in my opinion, looked a little bit hesitant from 19-16 ahead. Sort of just waiting for it to end, but he just wouldn't go away, Schriebler.
Yeah. Yeah, and you can't wait for it to happen in sport. You've got to make it happen. Well taken.
Three, love!
But he really needs to pick himself up quickly, Tommy Sugiarto, because he's playing on the, so to speak, good side now. Or at least he's playing at the side where Schriebler feels comfortable. But that's why he chose to finish the match on that side.
Service over! 1-3!
Oh, goodness, what now? He must have changed his mind, surely.
Yeah.
2-3!
Could easily have hit it long, I think, because he gets a little bit help from the drift.
Well, he said he needed to pick himself up. He's done that. Tommy Sugiarto.
3-3.
Yeah, and that's the sort of shot again that makes me think that Schriebler is struggling physically.
Yeah.
4-3.
It would be natural if his calf injury has sort of ruined his build-up to the Olympic qualification period, so that he's still not in as good shape as he would like to be.
Yeah, if you've got to have time off, then inevitably your stamina training suffers.
And there's been a lot of tournaments ever since.
So 5 straight points now for Sugiarto.
Well, like to see Zwiebler run a little bit more or a little bit faster, because I don't think Sugiyato could place that defense anywhere else than straight short.
Six of the last 7 points.
Service over, 6-4.
Good defense.
Six-all.
Smash from Sugiyato. Yeah, I think that, still think that was going wide.
Yeah. Attacking play from Zwiebler.
And that is where he is very good, isn't it? The counter attack.
Yeah. Needs to get the opponent a little bit off position in order to kill the attack. Mistakes that simply made, because it's not a winner if they go over or anything. It's just a transport shot.
Service over, 8-9.
Yeah, both men struggling now. Physically, this is a grueling match.
Service over, 8-all, play.
Oh, what a good smash there from Sugiarto. Guiding shot to the net from Mark Schwiebler. So who's going to have the advantage at the change of ends? And the answer is the left-handed Mark Schwiebler. An hour and 6 minutes into the match. And the players change ends for a final time. Well, it's not much of an advantage, but psychologically, for the former European champion, 1 point advantage and his favoured end.
Yeah, he won on his non-preferred end.
Yeah.
That's important. So, interesting to see if Thomas Sugiarto has a better game plan. That's often the case in the third game. Both players actually have better game plans for the non-preferred side. But so far, we can say that Schwiebler has done well.
11-10.
He's got more bite in his smashes here in the, towards the end of the match.
That's nice. Both men just giving the other a little tap after the good rally. And it has been played in great spirit this match, hasn't it? It's good to see.
I don't know if there's still this exchange between Germany and Indonesia, but I know 10 years or so, the sports ministry of each country had some kind of development. The Indonesian players were tested in Germany.
And, what physical testing?
Physical testing and playing some team matches, exhibition matches there.
Now, what's the umpire calling for here? What's the problem? Tournament referee has been called on, Ronnie DeVos of Belgium, our tournament referee. Now, what's the issue here? We might need medical attendant. A little bit of a graze with the dive there, do you think?
Maybe a band-aid.
Yeah. Ooh. Oh no, not the back again, please.
Yeah.
Asking for cold spray on his back. Oh, that is worrying because it's the back injury that has been so tiresome for him and so troublesome over recent months. That would be a huge pity. Somebody in the crowd again with the camera, and the umpire just explaining to the players that indeed she did make a mistake, and it is 11-12. Sugiarto back level. Well, this is a real gladiatorial battle, isn't it? The survival of the fittest.
Yeah.
Well, that's going well wide.
You can see by the body language of Tommy Sugiarto that he's struggling right now.
Yeah. Well, he too, like his opponent, has had his stamina training interrupted by those injury problems to his back. It's gone long.
14-12.
He really needs to change something right now. Otherwise, I think Mark Zwiebler will go on to the quarterfinals.
You see, there's suddenly a shuttle flies like that, and that really takes me by surprise because it goes against all the principles of what I've got set in my mind about the drift.
And it puzzles the players even more. It's so worrying when you feel that you have a read of the drift, and suddenly there's something that doesn't add up. Because then how can I trust all the other things that I've read about the drift so far in this match? And that means that you hesitate a little bit, and that's just 14-0. Terrible for a player to be hesitant.
Yeah.
So perhaps that's what Sugiarto needed. Quite successful with his body smashes lately, Mark Zwiebler.
Yes, two of them.
It's like he can't really get in the correct position. Or maybe I'm just trying to figure out too much from his injury break here.
No. He's afraid to unleash the smash, isn't he?
Yeah, and sort of to bend forward in some way. Yeah. Had he only converted the match point in the second game.
Yeah. Well, you can't live on ifs and buts and maybes. Sport is all about taking those chances, isn't it?
16-14. Play.
I must say that we've judged the stamina on Mark Zwiebler a little bit wrongly. He just looked tired.
Yeah. Oh, he did. Yeah. Oh my God, second wind. Brilliant.
And he's not playing clever tactics right now, Tomáš Ugarte, because he needs to take the 50-50 chances whenever they're there. So if Mark Sweeper plays close to the net, Tomáš Ugarte, he needs to go for the winning net shot. He cannot afford the rallies to go on and on, because whenever the rallies become longer and longer, his chances of winning them diminish.
Wow.
Now, that offers a lifeline to Tommy Sugiarto.
Service over!
Well, the movement to play that backhand from Tommy Sugiarto was very, very concerning.
Yeah.
I didn't like that at all. Yeah. Look at that.
Yeah. So, the last two rallies. No, sorry. It's only this rally. The other one was a missed service, but the sweepers made mistakes. That's where you sometimes like your coach to sort of see where is it that Sugiarto has problems moving to, but German coach is sitting in a very, very awkward position. Can't almost see the part of the court where Tomáš Sugiarto's on. You can see him there in the corner behind the yellow A-board.
See Schwebler saying to himself, just keep it calm.
Yeah. And he's changed his game since he got to 18. Hasn't played that backhand, long backhand corner at all. Oh, that's lucky.
Yeah, can't move for long. That. Oh, it's gone long. Would you believe it? And Tommy Sugiarto could not move at all for that clear. And he's back level at 18 all. Just look at this. Can't change direction.
No,
he gives it up. But it goes long.
And I would be very surprised if we see Tommy Sugiarto winning this match and finishing tomorrow's match.
Yeah.
Oh. Certainly fault on one of the sides.
Yeah.
Either it's a service fault because there's two movements, or it's a return fault.
Exactly. For moving before the serve was struck.
It's so tense right now. It's in.
There's a challenge here from Sugiarto. You thought it was in, Steen. He was called out by the line judge. Hawkeye will therefore make the decision for us. Well, this is crucial, quite obviously.
Very fair.
20. So match points, 18. Opportunities, two of them for Mark Schwiebler. Oh, and what a great return of serve.
And Schwiebler points to the baseline, thought it might have gone long.
Yeah, he simply couldn't get out of the way, yeah. Could he? Oh, one match point saved, a piece now. Mark Schwiebler, having saved a match point in the second game, comes through in three thrilling games against Tommy Sugiarto. 16-21, 22-20, 21-19 in the deciding game. Well, what courage by the left-handed German. 16-21. Saved that match point at 19-20 down in the second. Desperation defence in that final rally from Tommy Sugiarto. But you made a very good point, Steen, that I think the German probably has more chance of finishing a match tomorrow than Tommy Sugiarto. An hour and 21 minutes of fantastic badminton. And Mark Schwiebler goes through to the quarterfinal. Their confirmation of the score, 16-21, 22-20, 21-19 in the deciding game. after that excellent men's singles, we turn our attention now to men's doubles. And it features the qualifiers of Beri Angriawan and Rien Agunsoputro. They are up against the highly experienced number six seeds, Hiroyuki Endo and Nichi Hawakawa. This is from the third quarter of the draw, and here come the Japanese pair. Endo and Hawakawa, the number six seeds. And here's an interesting statistic, seen fourth appearance here for the Japanese pair. First time they've got beyond the first round.
It takes time to learn to play in this Doris and Iron.
Yeah.
Not easy at all.
Well, this pair, relatively new, played against each other in the final of the 2013 Southeast Asian Games. Formed their partnership at the Hong Kong Super Series event last year. Angriawan and Soputro. So Fien Dattan, our umpire for this one from India.